In this video, I'll show you how to plan your budget more effectively using the 50-30-20 rule in Notion. This monthly exercise will help you allocate your income more wisely to achieve a more balanced financial life. You will need two databases, one for an overview and the other for the different categories of money outflow. We'll first turn this page into full width by clicking on the three dots on the top right corner and toggle on full width. Let's start by creating a new database called Categories. We'll choose a table view and click on New Database. To achieve a cleaner look for table views, I like to go to the database settings to hide the vertical lines and database title. I will also delete the default text property. I will now begin to list down some of the different categories of money outflow, such as rent, utilities, transportation, groceries, and entertainment. For each category, I will assign a unique icon that best represents it. Then I'll add two number properties, one for the budget amount and the other for the actual amount. Before we forget, we can update the format to our preferred currency. Then I'll resize the column width to make the table view more compact. Before we start allocating a budget to each of these categories, this is where the 50-30-20 rule by Elizabeth Warren comes in. We will split our income into three parts, 50% for needs, 30% for wants, and 20% for savings. Put 50% of your money towards important things like bills, rent, groceries, and transport. Spend 30% of your money on fun stuff like eating out, movies, shopping, and holidays. And lastly, save and invest the remaining 20% of your money for things like emergencies, paying off debts, retirement, and big future plans. With that, we'll move on to create a second table view, which I will call Type. Again, I will choose to hide the vertical lines and database title. We'll also delete the default text property, which we don't need. There will just be three pages for this database view, namely needs, wants, and savings. I will add a page icon to better differentiate between these three pages. I will first add a number property for the income percentage. Here, I will update the number format to percent and put down the respective percentages 50, 30, and 20. Depending on your income and lifestyle, you can adapt the way you split your income, perhaps to something like 60, 30, and 10. But just make sure it adds up to 100%. What is important here is to pay attention to where you allocate your income and to know where your money is flowing to. Next, I will add a number property called budget. Then I will format it to the currency I'm using. Based on your estimate or average monthly income, multiply that by the percentage to determine the budget for your needs, wants, and savings. So if I take home $2,000 per month, it will be $1,000 for needs, $600 for wants, and $400 for savings. At the bottom of this property, we can then calculate the sum to make sure we add up correctly. Next, we want to connect our categories database to this new database. I will add a relation property and search for the categories database. Click on that and toggle on Show on Categories before clicking on Add Relation. Here, we can also optionally change the property icon. We don't really need to see the categories on this view, so we'll toggle to hide it. Before moving on, I'll quickly add a heading above each of these databases. We can now go back to the categories database to assign each category to their respective type, that is either needs, wants, or savings. I can also give this property a new icon just for the aesthetic, then move it over to the front to better assign the type when adding the new category. And to make it easier, I will add a grouping to this view to group by the type. I will choose to sort by menu and reorder to show in the order of needs, wants, and savings, and then hide the no type group. With that, we can easily toggle the respective group to view or hide the categories under it. I will now start planning my budget for each category. Under the budget property, we can click on calculate and choose to calculate the sum. To see these values on the above table, we will go back and add some properties. I will first add a rollout property to calculate the sum of the budget. I will call it budgeted, give it a new icon, and choose the categories relation. From there, choose the budget property, then calculate the sum. Then I will create a formula property called budget left. I will give it an icon before editing the formula to subtract the budgeted amount from the budget we set for each type. Then finish up by updating the number format to your currency. And under the budget left property, I will calculate the sum. I will now continue to set a budget for my other categories under savings and wants. And that's pretty much what needs to be done at the start of a new month. Then, at the end of each month, we then key in the actual amount for each of these categories, so that we can better prepare and budget for the following month. The great thing about grouping feature is that we can also configure the number beside it to calculate the sum as well. Now we also want to pull in those values to the above table view just to see everything side by side. I will add a new rollout property and name it actual and give it a new icon. Select the categories relation, the actual property, then choose to calculate the sum. Next, we'll calculate the actual amount left using the formula property. I will give it a new icon before editing the formula to subtract the actual amount from our budget. Then update the number format to your currency. This tells you how far you are from your budget, whether you went above or below it. This can help you decide if you need to cut back on certain spendings or that a different percentage of income allocation is needed. A bonus tip is that if you are not a minimalist like me, you can assign a different color for the page icon of needs, wants, and savings. This can help you better distinguish between each category. I hope you found this video helpful, and don't forget to subscribe for more.